Let me introduce viewers and ladies and gentlemen to our next session of the day. Point of view, gubernatorial guideline, keeping a balance between politics and position. To take it from here, I would like to invite on stage Rahul Kanwal, News Director, India Today and Aaj Tak.
We are privileged and delighted to welcome at the India Today Conclave East one of the most outspoken voices in the state of Bengal, the governor of the state, Mr. Jagdeep Dhankar. Thank you so much for gracing us with your presence at the India Today Conclave. It's great to have you with us. I want you, governor, to start out this conversation by laying out what you believe is right and wrong about the state of West Bengal today.
Let me congratulate you to the city of joy. And to have a leading media house here is a matter of privilege for everyone in the state of West Bengal. It was so pleasant for me when someone told me late night yesterday, Governor, we have seen your hoarding. Aur phir kaha, chalo kisi aur ka chehra to dikha. That happened. Coming back to the issue, state of West Bengal is a very important state of the Union. It is epicenter of culture. Decades ago, it was number one in industry. Right now, we are having serious issues of employment, lack of industrialization, absence of service sector, and those are painful issues. Let me tell you, Rahul, 2015 onwards, we have had 5 editions of Bengal Global Business Summit. 5. Cumulative investment projected is 12,30,000 crores, a huge, huge figure. And on the floor of the assembly, it was indicated more than 50% of the projects are at advanced stage of implementation. The governor is asking from the government, not the moon, but just some information. Where is this investment? Paschim Bengal ke kaun se bhu bhag mein wo investment hai? Who is doing it? No response is coming forth. That's a terrible situation. Imagine, just few days back, a projection is made. Some flyovers will come in the city of joy. The same announcement was made with respect to same flyovers in 2017. They are yet to start. Where are we heading? We are having this month expression of interest in for Tajpur port. Something is being said. Same expression of interest was invited 2 years earlier. This surely does not augur well for governance. I can tell you, my greatest worry is governance in the state is getting away from constitutional parameters. It is distancing itself from rule of law. And no one knows it better than the governor. In public domain, I have revealed only tip of the iceberg. But can you imagine? Bureaucracy that is supposed to be convinced of development is politically committed to the core. We have public servants engaged in political work. Everyone knows it. It is an open secret. The commitment is so deep They are unmindful of consequences. I don't say be politically neutral. The regime emanating from Indian Constitution calls upon them to be politically neutral. How can a public servant engage in political work? They do it 24/7. Let me tell you on this point, they are not just political workers, they are frontline political workers. If they retire, they are retained. This is a state that has more than 24 senior IPS officers who upon retirement are holding equivalent posts and eating into the cadre posts, a very worrisome scenario.
So, Governor Dhankar, in the manner in which the post of the governor was envisaged, the governor's role is supposed to be the linchpin of the constitutional apparatus of the state. How do you envision your role? Are you a guiding light? Do you see yourself as the principal critic? Do you see yourself as somebody who's been sent by the center to oppose the state government? Or do you see yourself as just doing your job and highlighting the problems that you see in the state?
Let me tell you, a governor is easy punching bag. If the government is of a particular party in the state and of a different party in the center, it's so easy to level allegations. I am very clear about it. I take guidance only from Indian Constitution. I am very firm. I cannot be directed to do a particular thing either by the state government or by the central government. But coming back to my role, on 30th of July 2019, I took oath. What does that oath say? That oath says, I will preserve, protect and defend Indian Constitution. It says in so many words. And second, it says, which is not noticed much, I will serve the people of the state of West Bengal. Now, what do you expect from a governor? Fear all around. All pervasive fear. Itna dar hai ki dar ke baar, darne ke karan, dar ki charcha nahi karte. And that dar, that fear is in every section of the society, high and mighty, rich and poor. And sir, find out, you will not find a human soul who will disagree with it. I ask a question quite often to anyone who has place in industry, bureaucracy, society, academia. Do you have the authority to buy half a bag of cement, 10 bricks out of your option? The answer is no, if the conversation is one-to-one. Can you imagine the pain a governor suffers who has to protect the Constitution? People for whom governor has respect. Anyone will have respect. They are source of inspiration. They will make one request. Our name may not be disclosed at the North Gate. I would never ever give out those names till I meet my maker. Second, what does democracy mean if there is fear? What does freedom mean if there is fear? What does constitution mean if there is fear? What does rule of law mean? I cannot disappoint people of the state that we must lose hope. We can't have fair elections. We can't have elections without violence. Some people ask me, why are you raising these issues? Does anyone disagree with me that democracy is founded on fairness of elections?
So how do you, Governor, anticipate the electoral process will roll out in the state of West Bengal? Elections will be announced in a few days from now. What kind of an election do you anticipate?
Rahul, I have been told, I have been briefed effectively by people concerned. The 2018 Panchayat elections were a shame on democracy. Shame on democracy. 2019 Lok Sabha elections, every phase was attended with violence. I have been making an appeal to everyone. 2021 का बहुत बड़ा महायज्ञ है. इस महायज्ञ में हर किसी को आहुति देनी है, अपना योगदान देना है. I am alive. It is job of the Election Commission of India, a very powerful body. But ordinary citizen has a big role to play. And the problem which we have is सरकारी वाहन, सरकारी दफ्तर, सरकारी पद का उपयोग राजनीति के लिए हो, वो डेमोक्रेसी के लिए अच्छा दिन नहीं है. ये हालात मैं देखता हूँ. लेट मी टेल यू, मीडिया टू विच यू बिलोंग, नॉट ओनली यू बिलोंग, यू आर पार्ट ऑफ एन एस्टेब्लिशमेंट दैट इज नेशनल एंड ग्लोबल इमेज. मुझे उस दिन से बहुत डर लगता है जिस दिन मीडिया डर जाएगा. मैं ये कहने की हालात में नहीं हूं कि ये हालात यहां नहीं है. जब मैंने क्राइम अगेंस्ट वीमन के बारे में एक ट्वीट किया, मेरा आधार राहुल क्या था? वी हैव 5 डिविजनल कमिश्नर्स, दे गेव मी द फिगर्स इन राइटिंग under their signatures. Each of the divisional commissioners attest written report of the district magistrate. Maine sirf compile karaya, not by me, by a senior man who is my secretary, who is senior to the chief secretary. Compilation hua, I put those figures. Home department ka tweet aata hai, they are wrong, manipulated, mischievous, all defamatory words, 6 adjectives used. Where are we heading? But that issue I am handling. Second is more critical. They have stopped giving those details. When I got a report only yesterday, I was updating, since some question may come up, SP Bankura, likh diya, these figures will not be shared. Now, if you go to Constitution, Article 167, I have high respect for the Chief Minister, elected Chief Minister, and a Chief Minister, the present one. But Constitution has used the word duty of the Chief Minister towards the Governor. There is 100% failure. No information which I sought has been given so far.
Governor Dhanka, you said that your role is to serve the people of the state of West Bengal
and protect constitution.
Is that not the state government's job? So if your job is to serve the people of the state of West Bengal, whichever party wins the election, they will say our job is to serve the people of West Bengal. The governor is supposed to be a figurehead, constitutional figurehead. He should perform his constitutional duties without speaking, doing press conferences, tweeting. The charge against you is that you act and you speak like a member of the opposition to the state government. How do you respond to this?
Rahul, whatever I have spoken, whatever I have written, whatever I have tweeted is on record. Would you be kind enough to point out that this is one particular action which I should not have taken? I indicated I am revealing in public domain tip of the iceberg. We are sitting on a volcano, not a fortnight passes without people being killed as a consequence of illegal bomb making. I am putting it to you. Can you imagine state apparatus operating one of the world's most vicious syndicate of thousands of crores?
Where is the evidence to
be? I'll tell you. It took the associations 15 months to seek audience with me. I said, if you don't have courage, if you don't come with material, why should I lend my ears? I know it is open secret. The syndicate operation, the transport associations, they came in good number, state and central. What they tell me, let me share it with you. If it is sent, one receipt of 3,000 rupees is ultimate passport. If a truck carries that receipt, the truck will not be questioned by anyone. The state apparatus in uniform being paid out of state exchequer will be serving the syndicate and mafia. For gitti, stone, 10,000. For coal, 20,000. Imagine.
But where's the evidence, Governor? Because
sir, receipts have been shown. Sir, you are a journalist. News is what is hidden. Just give 48 hours beyond this conclave, and you will accuse me. Governor, I charge you for understating a case. The system here is much worse. In the state of West Bengal, you have a ready-made script for another godfather. And as governor, if I become victim of fear, I better not sit in that chair. I am prepared to take any accusation against me. Someone has to join issue with me. I take this opportunity. I have enormous respect for Saugatji. He will be reacting immediately thereafter. Saugatda, I have great respect for you. Have a cup of tea with me. I'll come to your place. Tell me, do you disagree with me? Sir, no one, Rahul, has disagreed with me in private. They are helpless. The state of West Bengal cannot be taken to be a state within a state. It is nobody's fiefdom. If I go to Diamond Harbor and the instruction goes, governor will not get guard of honor. Kya Diamond Harbor kisi ki zagir hai? Kya wahan constitution nahi chalega? Sir, this governor can be accused of being lenient.
Lenient?
Very lenient.
Lenient.
I am telling you, Rahul, I am revealing to you only tip of the iceberg. There are so many issues we have in our bureaucracy. More multimillionaires than in commerce, industry and business in last 10 years. I am making this statement to you. This is one place cleansing has to take place very effectively if semblance of democracy has to survive. And let me tell you.
So are you advocating Paribartan? Are you advocating Paribartan in the state of Bengal?
No. What I am saying is, I am not a stakeholder in politics. I am sure about it. Take me at my face value. I am a stakeholder in governance. I am a stakeholder like everyone else in purity of election process. I am a stakeholder that if verdict is stolen by public servants acting as political workers, that will be a sad day for democracy. What comes out of that machine in sublime manner with purity, we must bow down to that. But if we can have bureaucrats whose postings is like supari posting, they will control the political outcome. Sir, we are about to celebrate 75th great occasion, Independence Day celebrations. Can we have this kind of situation? Sir, state of West Bengal deserves to be only at number one. Where is industry? Where is service sector? Where is investment? Every year you will see 10, 20 people. They are respected industrialists. They will be around. No one has come. Nandigram and Singur. You can see the impact all through. We have missed opportunities. We have missed great opportunities. And that is why we have flight of human capital. Our human capital flight is very painful to the governor. When I find every university in the world can boast of a Bengali mind. And here, we have to live up to those traditions.
Sir, given your strong views on the state of affairs in the state of West Bengal and how bad things are, I wonder, what is your personal equation with Chief Minister Mamata Banerjee? When you meet Didi, How does that conversation go? What happens?
It is exactly as should be between a governor and the chief minister.
Which is what?
It has to be of the highest decorum. It has to be one of instant connectivity. From my side, I give great weightage, highest weightage, to anything that comes from the Honorable Chief Minister. I am not in doubt about it. And she is a very experienced politician of the country. I only wish she had not shown that distancing from Constitution. Rahul, for me, you are not an outsider. I will feel sad and weep if anyone will call Arun Puriji an outsider in the state of West Bengal. How can a chief minister go in that refrain? Don't we know Indian Constitution? We the people. Why did Rabindranath Tagore relinquish his title for what happened hundreds of kilometers away at Jallianwala Bagh? Why did Netaji went all over the world to secure freedom for us? Why did, let's say, Khudiram Bose, a young boy, a young lad, led his life where? And where was he buried? Sir, challenge can't be beyond political. Political challenge, I'm not concerned. Existential challenge worries me. So this refrain of outsider is absolutely, absolutely unconstitutional. I cautioned the Chief Minister when on a particular issue she wanted to go to United Nations. Surely this can't be countenanced. A political leader may be on road, on agitation, but can an elected Chief Minister, under the oath of office to protect Indian Constitution, be on the street against law emanating from Indian Parliament? These are the issues.
Governor Dhankar, the DMK founder and former Tamil Nadu Chief Minister C.N. Annadurai once said that, you know, like goats, goats don't need beards and Indian states don't need governors. That it's a West, it's not required. So what do you say to people who look at the post of governor and say that he's principal mischief maker sent by the center to destabilize the state, and at a philosophical level, India doesn't require the post of a governor at all? Why do you think governors are required?
Let me tell you, you will not find a support from Mamtaji on this point.
She wants you here?
No, she wouldn't support you.
No, but do you think she wants you here?
No, she knows that this government has nothing to do regarding tinkering by the governor. No, she knows it. I will never cross Lakshman Rekha of Constitution. I urge everyone with folded hands, please let me know one instance. Call me names you wish to. Call me anybody's agent. I am not in doubt. I am agent of the Indian Constitution. I follow script of the Indian Constitution and I follow it fearlessly. Number one. Number two, commissions have been there about governor being there or not being there. I am very clear, founding fathers have thought something about it. The constitution which Dr. Ambedkar has given us has involvement in it. Being in Raj Bhavan, Kolkata, I can personally say, maybe someday I will write, this is a very important post. Not about governance, but about protecting a sense and spirit of the Indian Constitution. And that a sense and spirit of the Indian Constitution is being heavily strained here because we have politicization of bureaucracy and police. Total.
But how
and
is this
criminalization of politics.
Governor, how is this different from other states? Because, you know, the ruling Trinamool Congress and the Indian opposition can say, you are saying all of this because you've been appointed by the center to come here. If you were in a BJP ruled state like Uttar Pradesh or like Madhya Pradesh or Gujarat or any other state, you would not see the kind of shortcomings. And even if you saw some shortcoming, you might counsel and advise the chief minister in private. You won't do press conferences or start tweeting about it.
Rahul, it's a good question. And I'm glad you are giving me an opportunity. I don't tweet immediately. I don't go to the media immediately. I exhaust all avenues. Trust me. For example, by birth I'm a farmer. 9 crore farmers in the state, in the country. Each of them has got 14,000 rupees. Directly in the bank, no middleman, no intermediary. They got it. And it is not loan. It is not subsidy. It is 100% grant. And it is available to every farmer, irrespective of holding. In the state of West Bengal, over 70 lakh farmers, my brothers and sisters, they have not got a single penny. Each of them has been deprived of 14,000 rupees, each of them. Total deprivation is 10,000 crores. Will anyone take it as good politics or prudent economics? I ask a question. Why it is being done? Spoken to the chief minister, written to the chief minister. Why andata ke pet par laat kyun mari ja rahi hai? Kaun sa karan hai? Nothing had to be done. All that had to be done was share data. Now, after the governor has battled with the issue for 15, 16 months, now you take a political stance. I wish.
Didi said yesterday that data has been shared.
Sir, read what she has said. I hope someday, not only you, anyone in the state will ask questions to Didi. No one dare does. I am saying it on record.
She's coming to the India Today conclave. She'll be answering many questions, Governor.
Sir, please, at my very special suggestion and a request with folded hands, update yourself with the state of affairs. I am extremely cautious in using my words, but we are facing a situation where emergency scenario pales into insignificance, more with respect to media. Don't.
So you keep saying this about the media. You are sitting live at the India Today Group Forum, the East Conclave, saying whatever you want. So what emergency are you referring to?
Sir, what I'm saying is, and I indicated earlier, wherever I go in the state of West Bengal, and you can take me to be widely traveled, and I interact with the local media, I frankly tell them one thing, which I told here also a while ago. Us din se dar lagta hai. The media dar jayega. Aur sabko aankhon mein aankh dalkar kehta hu, aap nahi dare hue ho, ye main nahi manta. Mere se kisi ne disagree nahi kiya hai.
Main disagree kar raha hu.
Kyunki aap bahar ke hain. Is baat ko lekar.
Hamare local reporter.
Nahi, nahi, sunye, sunye meri baat. आपके लोकल रिपोर्टर से मैं चर्चा कर सकता हूं. आप बाहर के इसलिए हैं कि आप यहां समय नहीं देते हैं. यू आर आवर इंटीग्रल पार्ट. आप यहां पर 7 दिन बिता लेंगे तो आप मेरे को कटघरे में खड़ा करेंगे कि हालात तो इतने भयानक थे, बॉडी का टेम्परेचर तो 104 था, आप 100 क्यों बता रहे थे. सर कितना डरा हुआ है, इतना डरा हुआ है कि डर की बात लोग नहीं कर पाते हैं. सबसे खतरनाक फियर वो है दैट वी इवन फियर टू टॉक अबाउट द फियर विच इज देयर. सर स्टेट ऑफ वेस्ट बंगाल एंड कोलकाता हैज वेरी इमिनेंट पीपल. आई एम अनरिस्ट एवरी डे.
इफ थिंग्स आर सो बैड, डू यू थिंक दिस इज अ स्टेट दैट्स नाउ फिट फॉर प्रेसिडेंट्स रूल टू बी इम्पोज?
नो, आई वुडंट रिफ्लेक्ट ऑन दीज इश्यूज इन पब्लिक डोमेन, यू नो इट. बट
इतना कुछ तो बोल दिया सर आपने.
नहीं,
फिर इसमें क्या है?
नहीं नहीं राहुल, यू आर बीइंग जजमेंटल.
मैंने
नहीं मैंने बोला नहीं है. मैंने ग्राउंड रियलिटी को रिफ्लेक्ट किया है और ये ग्राउंड रियलिटी परसेप्शन नहीं है, ये ग्राउंड रियलिटी इसलिए है जब मैं कहता हूँ इंप्लॉयमेंट की बात। कितने लोगों की मेरे पास चिट्ठियाँ आती हैं, क्या कहते हैं। दी अदर डे राज्य सैनिक बोर्ड सेक्रेटरी केम टू मी या कर्नल, व्हाट ही टोल्ड मी आई कैन नेवर बिलीव, आई नेवर थॉट दिस कुड हैपन। आई टोल्ड कर्नल हाउ आर थिंग्स, ही सेड सर देयर इज वन पॉइंट ऑफ वरी। आई सेड एज गवर्नर इफ आई कैन डू एनीथिंग आई विल कॉन्ट्रीब्यूट। दोज हु हैव गोन टू आर्म फोर्सेज फ्रॉम स्टेट ऑफ वेस्ट बंगाल 40% डोंट कम बैक हियर, वेरी वेरी बिग फिगर। वाई वी नीड टू हैव अपॉर्चुनिटीज। अपॉर्चुनिटी होंगी कहाँ राहुल, मुझे बताइए ना, 10 साल में क्या आ गया, कौन सा उद्योग आ गया। माई वेरी डियर फ्रेंड डॉक्टर अमित मित्रा, स्टेटिस्टिक्स में गुड, वी डोंट नीड स्टेटिस्टिशियन, आई वॉन्ट टू सी ऑन ग्राउंड। जिस दिन डॉक्टर अमित मित्रा मुझे बता देंगे कि 2,30,000 करोड़ का इन्वेस्टमेंट यहाँ है, जिस दिन डॉक्टर मित्रा मुझे बता देंगे कि दुर्गापुर अंडाल एयरपोर्ट के अंदर पहले तो 26% लिया, अब 26% से 47% लिया, ऑन माई टेबल पीपल से इट्स अ स्कैम दैट इज अनफोल्डिंग। मैं जानना चाहता हूँ स्टेट का पैसा खर्च हो रहा है, एडवांटेज कौन ले रहा है। सर व्हाट इज हैपनिंग इन द स्टेट, आई डोंट वॉन्ट टू गो इन टू इंडिविजुअल सिचुएशंस, इज वेरी सम 24/7। It's a flourishing industry where people make hay through most non-transparent corrupt means, and that is something which cannot and should not be countenanced in democracy, and I am sure no one should disagree with this principle.
Governor Dhankar, you've had your say. Dr. Mitra will be here in a short while from now. The Chief Minister is going to come. She'll respond to many questions, and I've never seen a governor speak as forcefully, as forthrightly as you have over the last half an hour. We don't want to sit on judgment. You know, you've said your piece. We leave everyone who's sitting here, who's watching across the India Today network, to make up their minds on what they make of whether you're doing the right thing, the wrong thing. Should governors be taking such an approach? Should they avoid such an approach? But we thank you very much for having...
I'll say two things.
Yes.
Kabir Guru Tagore, what he said, where mind is without fear, head is held high, halat nahi hai. We have to follow now what Vivekananda said, awake till the goal is achieved. I am grateful to the very important media house of the country, a vital segment of democratic life, to have afforded me this opportunity to unfold what was in my heart in an unqualified manner. But I have been unfair that I have released only a very small part of it.
So hopefully we'll have you back for more. Thank you so much, Governor Dhankar, for joining us at the conclave. Thank you.